Welcome, fellow freaks, geeks, and nostalgic 90s nerds to my channel, Slime and Slashers, where, yep, you may have guessed it, we talk about everything from Nickelodeon slime to horror movie slashers, but plenty of stuff in between. Today, I'm going to be doing something that I haven't done in quite a while. I'll be showing you guys a little vlog, and it's more specifically a book shopping vlog, kind of. There's some B-roll footage in a bookstore, but you know, I don't really show that much. But really, it was more of a whole weekend vlog. So I went to the bookstore, as I said. Also, by the way, there was a lot of bees involved, and that wasn't on purpose. Went to a baseball game, went to this awesome side road, like, gas station place called Buc-ee's, which is incredible. It's like a southern chain of these huge gas stations, and oh my god, they've got some of the most incredible stuff. But yeah, Buc-ee's, that's one of the things we did too. And all this was in Pensacola. So today, the day I'm filming this, is August 25th. The day I went on this trip was August 14th to the 15th. So, you know, just over 10 days ago. But I want to take you guys on that journey. I also went to some breweries, because I'm big into visiting different breweries. And speaking of beer, because I mentioned the breweries I went to, I just went and restocked up on beer here at home, and I found out that they have restocked, because it hasn't been around in a year, their Oktoberfest beers and their pumpkin beers! I'm so excited. This is a local brewery here in New Orleans called Urban South. This is their Oktoberfest, which is a very fall type of beer. You'll see this around a lot during fall. It's seasonal. Also, another seasonal beer, as I mentioned, is a pumpkin beer or a pumpkin ale. And so I bought a few of those as well. The pictures are up on my Instagram if you want to check it out, of all the beer that I bought, because it was way more than just this one. I'm a big fan of Sam Adams, even though technically it's not like a craft brewery, like not a small craft brewery, but I do still consider it craft beer. So this is not Sam Adams in this glass, but I have a Sam Adams glass. And I did buy two Sam Adams beers tonight when I restocked up on beer. One was a pumpkin ale called Jack O, and the other is their Oktoberfest, which I think is amazing. I had it last year. I'm so excited that it's back. I wait all year for this. So yes, freaking pumpkin beers are here. Lots of people get excited about pumpkin spices, or you know, pumpkin latte or pumpkin desserts, which I also get excited for that stuff too. However, pumpkin beer is kind of like my main jam, just because I discovered I liked it like about 2 years ago and been going down the rabbit hole trying to try different ones ever since. And it's super hard to find in the South for some reason. Stores have them, but they have them like not very often. Like once the season starts, they have them and then they're gone, and it's hard for them to restock. And they don't have a very big, you know, choice. They don't have a lot of options when you go to look at the pumpkin beers or the Oktoberfest. So when you see them, you have to snag them, and that's what I did. So this is, even though it's a Sam Adams glass, it's the Urban South beer. So I'm gonna take a sip. Cheers, guys. It's good. It's good. It's light. Very ambery. It's good. I like it. Toasty. Malty. I like it. Anyway, enough about beer. I know you guys came here for books, so let's go over to the footage and I'll show you some stuff I saw at the bookstore. There was a cute cat, by the way, and I found some amazing gems. I'll be doing a book haul video later. I also went to the beach on this trip, so that's another B there. So baseball, Buc-ee's, books, beer, and beach. That's a lot of bees. And at the baseball game, they had some big booms, that's another bee there, because they had a fireworks show. So I'll show you all the footage now, have some music underneath. I might pop in with a voiceover here or there, I don't know yet. But when we come back after all that footage and I close out, I want to show you guys some cool, like, haul stuff that isn't books, like some horror movie posters, a horror magazine, and some other things, and then we'll wrap it out. So see you back here after the footage. American brown ale. There's the front side of the glass. Here is the name of the brewery. Pretty cool. These are always really good. It's dark brown, nutty. It's got a toasty flavor, kind of like toffee-ish, you know. So, pretty good. Cheers. Halloween stuff at Buc-ee's. Guys, that was my weekend trip to Pensacola, Florida. Also, we were in the Perdido Key area as well. So it was Pensacola, Perdido Key. They're very close together, about 30 minutes apart. Again, Buc-ee's is on the way to Florida. Also, you can visit it on the way back. And yeah, Buc-ee's had some Halloween decorations out, so hopefully you guys enjoyed a little peek at that. I was really excited to find that. I didn't buy anything because I'm saving up. I'm gonna go shopping with my friend Kat. We're gonna do a whole shopping vlog, and we're going to buy a whole bunch of Halloween decor. And my main goal this year for Halloween purchases is to buy Halloween mugs, because somehow I have absolutely no Halloween mugs, and it's atrocious. It's just insane that I have none, and I must rectify this. I must. So that is what I'll be on the lookout for. Hopefully I'll find some. So the show and tell, as I told you guys about, I found this recently at a convenience store. I think it was actually a Walgreens, not a convenience store, but I snagged it because I thought, hey, why not have a Stephen King magazine? It's a special edition magazine. It's called Hollywood Story here, and it's a special issue. I kind of wish, I mean, I like the new Pennywise, but I wish this was the Tim Curry version. It would just feel a lot more old school. But there's tons of amazing pictures in here, as you guys can see. Sorry about the glare. Let me try to, ooh, I like this page. I'm a big fan of The Shining, so that's pretty neat. Of course, the movie is not much like the book. There's a lot of differences, and Stephen King notoriously hated it for a while. Here's some of his other non-horror stories like Shawshank, although you could say that there is some horror involved. And then there's The Green Mile down there, both great films. But yeah, I'm excited to have found this recently, and I'm going to dig into this and use it as like a light reading in between books during October time when we get there. And speaking of October time, I just dusted off, and I'm going to show you more about this. I don't want to give away anything because I'm going to reveal the insides of this binder when we get into fall. I have a whole vlog planned for the first day of fall, and I've got a lot of fun things that I'm going to do in that vlog, including reading a special book that is perfect for the kickoff to autumn. Also, I'll be baking, and I'll be showing you my Halloween clothes, and I'll be showing you the inside of this binder, which is my Halloween binder. I just printed out a new cover sheet. Pusheen, and of course, Pinhead.
We'll tear your soul apart.
Just, oh.
Your suffering will be legendary, even in hell.
Anyway, I love Hellraiser. It's pretty much my favorite horror movie ever of all time. I know that might seem like a weird choice because I'm so like clean cut, and it's like totally a really weird movie and not clean cut at all. But yeah, there's some cool stuff in here, and I'll just, you know, my old cover page was an old party invitation that my family and I printed out for one of our past Halloween parties, and it's in the shape of a tombstone. So that was what my old cover sheet was. Now I printed out a new one, and I'm ready to fill this binder up with plans and materials that I'll need for September, late September, and October time. So pumped to finally get this out of the closet and actually start to use it soon. And finally, I teased some horror movie posters. There's one behind me, if you guys can see. It's Hellraiser. It's brand new. I got this off of Etsy. Really awesome shop. I'll link the shop here below. I believe the store owner's name is Phil. I think it's called Phil Artsy, but it's going to be linked below. And yeah, isn't this cool? Hellraiser down. Like, that's thematic, because I love Hellraiser, like I said just a second ago. Here's some stuff I bought from a different Etsy store. And I'll also link this one below. This is a very minimalistic poster for the Halloween tree. I just love how there's pumpkins in the tree. And this is one of the books I'll be reading in October, by the way. Very short book by Ray Bradbury, of course. Like, basically the master of Halloween time. And finally, the last show and tell piece, an awesome poster of The Fog. And all of this will be framed. I'll probably switch it out with some of my posters back there in those frames. I like to switch up posters a lot. I hate when posters aren't in frames, so I would never put one up without a frame. But yeah, look at this awesome Fog poster. I love the green. This is one of my favorite horror movies as well. I have to really try hard not to watch all my favorite movies every single October. I have to force myself not to watch a lot of these movies and to wait a couple of years in between viewings, or else I'd never get any new horror movie watching done. But anyway, that was my vlog, that was my show and tell, and as you can tell, I'm getting into the spooky spirit. Even though it's still the end of August, I feel like September is right around the corner, very literally. It's almost here. And that means it's almost fall, even though it doesn't feel like it at all here in flippin' New Orleans. But hey, that's the same old story every year. Well, for this time, guys, that's it for me. Hope you enjoyed. Please leave a comment about anything you'd like to comment on. I'd love to know if you have any ideas for books you want me to read in September or October. I would definitely take that into consideration. I love suggestions, and I like to review things and talk about things that you guys want to hear me talk about. So leave any of those down below in the comments. And if you enjoyed the video, please consider leaving a like, because that means so much. What also means a lot is that you took the time to watch the video. I know they can be long. Appreciate you guys so much. And for this time, that's it for me. And cheers, guys. Till next time, keep on killing it. Bye.
Hello, hello. It's too bright for you.
Hey, what are you doing?
Get it from the books.
Stop snapping.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
I wanted to change that poster out. Are you done crashing?
No.